and welcome to the release video for version 10 of the Google Ads API. I'm Laura Chevalier, a developer relations engineer on the Google Ads API team, and I'll be walking you through some of the biggest changes in this release. Before we start, please note that the legacy AdWords API will be sunsetting on April 27th of this year, so all developers must complete their migrations to the Google Ads API by then. That said, we have plenty to cover, so let's get started. In version 10, all GET methods are removed. If a service only had a GET method, the service is also being removed in this release. Our best practices have always recommended avoiding GET methods in production and using search or search stream instead. So we hope this removal won't require any changes from you. Speaking of reporting queries, reporting users might also be interested in a new meta parameter, omit unselected resource names, which can help reduce the size of your response payloads. When set to true, the response from the Google Ads service will only return resource name fields that you explicitly request in the select clause of your query. Smart Campaigns have exited beta and entered general availability. Smart Campaigns are Google's most efficient solution for small businesses and help businesses get discovered on Google in those relevant moments. So definitely check those out. Performance Max campaigns now support asset group signals, which advertisers can use to inform their campaign about who is most likely to convert. As a reminder, all Smart Shopping and local campaigns will be migrating to Performance Max later this year. You can check out the announcement on our blog, linked in the video description, for more details. The customer and customer client resources each now have a status field, which will make it easier to understand, manage, and audit your account hierarchies. Status can be enabled, canceled, suspended, or closed. We've been working on improving audience targeting and are excited to introduce a completely new resource for this, the audience resource, which can be used as a criterion type. An audience is a targeting option that allows you to intersect different segment attributes, such as detailed demographics and affinities, to create audiences that represent sections of your target segments. Alongside this resource, we have a new audience service to manage your audiences. With every major new release, required minimum functionality will be updated. For V10, we've added new requirements for Performance Max and Smart Campaigns. We are also documenting the required minimum functionality for other developer tools such as shopping, hotel, and app campaigns, and simplifying standard shopping campaigns to align with full-service campaigns. And finally, we're adding a diff tool to our developer documentation, which will be extremely useful when it comes to upgrading your application to the latest major version of the Google Ads API. With this tool, you can easily find out which services and resources were added, removed, or changed in the latest version, and see a diff of the precise change. All in all, we have a lot of updates coming your way in version 10. We've discussed several of them, but have a look at our release notes for a more detailed list of all of the changes. You can find that, as well as some other useful links, in the video description. That's all for now. Thanks for joining.